and against iBUYPOWER. And the most interesting thing about that game for me was the fact that everybody calls Epsilon Shoxilon, you know, as a joke kind of term. But I believe, if I'm not mistaken, that Shox was actually bottom fragging for his team there, which was definitely a very interesting point indeed. But here we go. We're into the game. We are on Inferno, as you can see. Epsilon, I do believe they won the knife round, and as expected, they did decide to stay. So we're into the pistol round. Kyanite, take it away.
All right, here we go. GMX.
Throw for skins.
Throw for skins. Well, I think it was PRB during the veto at the end there where he just winked at Shoxy and said, 15-all, yeah? 15-all, 15-all. We don't want NIP anywhere near the quarters, semis, and grand final. But it's going to be SF and Kiyoshima. London Conspiracy answer back really fast. FX Yo is going to rotate through Ruins, and it is 3v3. FX Yo drops the man from Portugal in Rubinho, but Polly is quick to pounce and get the return frag.
Yep, he is indeed. So Shox making his way back from CT spawn. He is going to find a player there just over on the edge of Ruins. And we can see that GMX not right down to only 10 single points of HP into him. Polly gets another kill in the round. And let's see if Shox can finish this up. He's got two players to come up against, and he's got a defuse. Not going to happen, and the T's get the first round on the board there. Good start for the Norwegians.
Yeah, and that's the thing about Inferno. Granted, it's a slightly CT-sided map, despite all the changes that have happened to the map,
yeah.
You know, over the years in comparison to CS 1.6. But with how overpowered the pistols are in CSGO, on the T side, buy armor, keep your Glocks, rush somewhere like Apps, rush somewhere, for example, up Banana. And even though LC lost two men early on,
yeah,
they did very, very well to come back and win the round. It's so crucial for them because it's CT sided, they can now hopefully take a 3-0 lead.
Oh yeah, indeed, we will have to see. So of course now, because the London Conspiracy Squad have been able to take that first round, they will be able to get more firepower in the bank and buy those all-important rifles. So we'll see if they will be able to carry that momentum through, or whether Epsilon will do a surprise like they did in their first game of the day yesterday and actually win the eco round in round number two, which they did against NIP on Dust 2. I have a feeling it may not be quite as easy today. And I'm looking forward to seeing how these two teams perform. You know, it's very early on. We both know that, you know, everybody here, of course, as you'd expect on a Sunday morning, hasn't had much sleep the night before. And it'll be interesting to see how much of a factor that plays in this next match.
Yep. Terrorists with AKs. And they're playing very slow and methodical here. They don't want to rush into those overpowered CZ-75 because that's where the CZ-75s can really deal damage,
yep,
at close quarter. Close quarter combat is where you want those CZ-75s. You just want to hold an angle and wait for someone to run into your crosshair. And if one of these CTs gets a frag, picks up an AK, who knows what might happen. And for a second there, it looked like one of the CTs was actually going to sneak that down through mid. Shox gets the first frag, SF as well, and the CZ-75s reign supreme. And this was what we were talking about. This is the damage the CZ-75s can do, but maybe, just maybe, Chewie, it's not over yet.
No, we've got to remember that although GMX is still alive and can do damage, he's only got 5 HP, but as soon as I say that, Shox and GMX, that man, do finish it off. So there we go, we kind of half called it. I said there was a good chance after Epsilon took the eco in the second round of their first game yesterday that they could do it, and that's exactly what they've done here. So how is that going to end of the Norwegian? for it. And I think in some respects, although
maybe it's the Epsilon factor coming into place where it just seems like teams end up winning the pistol round, then end up losing and find themselves ecoing and then somehow manage to win the eco. But Shox is going to push apps. He's been spotted and PRB is not going to miss from there.
No, he's definitely not. So the last man left alive in that A area, although we have actually got SF starting to rotate through Arch now, but it's going to be GMX, the man on your screen, with that Nova shotgun in hand. And let's see what damage he can do with it. SF is going to pick up Robina here.
It's so happening again.
Yeah, exactly. It's a 4-on-4 situation, but it looks like that bomb's going to be heading back over towards B. There are going to be people starting to rotate now for the CTs. There's already two on the bomb side. Let's see if London Conspiracy can successfully push through. That's the first. That's the second. Although there is still one player left at the back of the side, and that's going to be Kiyoshima. He's going to be completely overrun, and it's all going to be left up in the hands of GMX, who will go down. PRB gets rewarded with a bomb plant just to get themselves some more money in the bank. And London Conspiracy on the T side get a 3-1 lead.
Yeah, and Epsilon are going to force the buy, Chewy. FAMAS is coming out. GMX could afford an M4, but he sacrificed the M4 for no helmet. But then again, do you really need a helmet up against the AK-47s? Maybe not.
Maybe not indeed, but you know, another point to make here is that, of course, we've got one quarterfinal already confirmed, which is Fnatic versus MAUS. Fnatic, of course, placing first in A, and MAUS Sports placing fourth in Group B. But of course, whoever wins this game has got to face up against either Dignitas Titan or virtus.pro, and that is no small feat whatsoever. So, you know, whoever progresses through this, when they head on to their quarterfinal match, which I would assume wouldn't start in too long a time, they've got a big task on their hand right from the start. But here we go into round number 5.
The rain gets that opening frag for London Conspiracy on the B bomb site. And I wasn't actually surprised to see London Conspiracy quickly push up Banana. They've had a lot of success there in the previous rounds. So I'm sure what they were trying to do there was try and fake it, make it look like what they were trying to do in the last rounds and force the rotation to come in from one of the Epsilon players towards the B bomb site. And it's exactly what they've done. Now the two CTs are on the B bomb site and two CTs are on the A bomb site. And because of how big the A bomb site is, if you can manage to fake the B push and maybe just maybe force the Arch player on the A bomb site to maybe just rotate through CT spawn, you can literally 4v1 that lone CT in pit if you try to push the A bomb site and try to get the bomb down.
But by the looks of things, the CTs are holding strong, so still two on A and two on B, and GMX is going to be the first man to meet up with somebody here, and he's spotted them, and he backs away, and rightly so. He's got the support from that player in pit, which I believe will actually be Shoxy, if I'm not mistaken. But they've actually been able to wrap through, so that mistake of him going back onto the A bomb site has allowed the T's to push through Arch, and here we go. They're going to get onto B with only 7 seconds left. Are they going to be able to get the bomb down? In comes the rotation. FXGO does find a player on the site, and that's going to be Skirk out of the count. And with 1 single second left on the clock, London Conspiracy plant the bomb. Talk about late.
LC do find themselves two men down. It's Rain 1v3, using the smoke to his advantage, but they are spraying him through it. And at the end of the day, they saw where the traces were coming from that AK-47. And it is going to be 3-2. And to be fully honest, that wasn't bad from LC. You know, you're on the lead side. The most important thing is that they keep getting that bomb down, because it'll make sure their economy keeps flowing. It'll make sure they keep getting the money in the bank that they need to potentially hit the 5 or 6 rounds which they need on this T side on Inferno.
Of course, and their economy isn't looking too great. They are going to be able to buy up here, and of course, we'll see what they do if they do lose this next round, of course. But I'm looking forward to the rest of this game with the way that we're already seeing these two teams play just in the first 5 rounds. I have a feeling it could be close. I mean, you know, we were talking earlier on before the game went live, and we had a feeling that this could really be one that goes down to the death. Of course, you know, some people are saying, well, why don't they just go, you know, 15-15 and draw
it?
Yeah, to get rid of Nip. But, and I agree with Thorin's point, you know, earlier on that he made, like, there is no, as as far as he's aware, official ruling is because it's very, you know, difficult to distinguish how a player isn't playing their best if they are trying to sit back once they reach 15 rounds. But, you know, still, it's a difficult one to call. I have a feeling that, you know, these teams are still going to try their best and make sure that they have a good result and keep that momentum going into the quarterfinal stages.
There we go. We've got Kiyoshima, who's going to be the CT on the B-bomb site. SF, or Super Fighter, is going to be the second man on the B-bomb site. It's quite interesting to see these CT setups. Epsilon, they opt to put two CTs on the B-bomb site. There's a lot of teams like iBUYPOWER who literally, I think, they just leave Steel on the B-bomb site to push down Banana by himself and then stack the A-bomb site in return. And the thing is, to do something like that, it's so crucial to push that CT down to the bottom of Banana, because if he dies, it gives you that early warning. You can start rotating around from the A-bomb site a lot faster.
Yeah, you can indeed. And you can see, actually, talking about Banana, that there are three, make that four players now stacked up over there as they are joined by, I believe that is PRB making his way over there now. So only going to be one player, which is Polly on that A bomb site. And we will see if he's going to be able to create any noise or whether he's going to back away. And that's exactly what he's going to do. In comes the flashes in to the B bomb site. It's going to be back and forth. SF does find one, but through the smoke, he gets shot by Rubino in the head. So it's a 3-on-3, all even situation here. And once again, London Conspiracy are able to get the bomb down on B, and they've had a really good success rate with those bomb plants here.
Yeah, especially Rubino. Hat trick already, you might make it four. It's going to be Polly to drop shocks, leaving FXYO, the new Epsilon recruit, of course, 1 versus 3. But it's worth mentioning that all the LC players are on low HP, but it's not going to matter. Rubino with 4 kills. And I completely agree with what you were saying, Chewy. Epsilon have made it far too damn easy for LC to get into that B bomb site.
And they're going to be punished for it now. They've not got too much money in the bank, unfortunately, so it looks like they are going to eco here. Yep, a couple of CZ75s coming in. We've actually seen Kiyoshima with a Deagle, and we will see what work he can do with it. But this should, if things go according to script, of course, be 5-2 in favor of the Norwegian side. But we've seen some pretty crazy early rounds already with a couple of eco wins, so you know you can't put it past the Epsilon side to do something. But that's already a good start there for Skurk as he shuts down GMX. But Kiyoshima with the 1-deag into Polly answering back. And FXYO is actually going to get one, onto Rain, and then Polly went down to a CZ75. I do apologize. Kiyoshima with the second. Is he going to be able to get the third? And this is back and forward. We've only got two more T players left alive. They have got AK-47s, but they've got to be really, really careful now here, Kaya Knight.
Yeah, brilliant Deagle work from Kiyoshima. And again, Chewy, we're starting to see what we keep reiterating, how overpowered the pistols are in CSGO.
Right. Yeah.
Some people think it's a bad thing. Personally, I love it, because in older versions of the game, we were talking to Sir Scoots about it yesterday in the hotel, where when you'd find yourself on an eco, it'd be like, right, we got weapons, we're going to win this anyway, but not in CSGO. Ooh. Kiyoshima, 1-deag. He's got 3 so far, only has PRB left to deal with, and we could just be on the verge of seeing one phenomenal round from Kiyoshima and that lovely Deagle Blaze of his.
And there we go. SF is going to finish things off. Kiyoshima more than happy just to hide, and not only do Epsilon take the eco round, they also pick up 3 AK-47s for their trouble, which of course then means that they're going to be really sitting happy with their economy for the fact that only 2 players have got to buy. Having a look, you know, FXYO has spent a lot of money and he's splashed the cash on that AWP, but we know how good he can be potentially with that rifle. So let's see in the early stages of this match and in the early stages of the second day on Championship Sunday just what he can quite do with the big green gun.
Playing Championship Day Sunday, it just reminds me of Monday Night Football. But there we go, GMX is going to push all the way down Banana. Kiyoshima gets the second kill. And at 5 versus 3, we know what the CZs can do and the Deagle can do. I know we keep reiterating this. And Skurk, as a matter of fact, gets the 1-deag onto Kiyoshima. FXYO drops Polly. But unfortunately, it's a little bit harder to get those opening frags with only the pistols on the T side in comparison to the CT side, where you can just hold an angle and wait for the terrorists to come to you and try and run the clock down.
Yeah, 100%. So round number 9 we go in, and we are all even here between the two squads. 4-4 it is, as you can see at the top. And now London Conspiracy, have a look at that economy there. They are going to be able to buy, but it's not sitting too pretty for them if they do lose this round. Of course, if they get the bomb down, then that will, you know, that will help in some respects. But yeah, you know, we will see. It's going to be an interesting round. You know, London Conspiracy, they aren't going to be too bothered so far. They've had a couple of mistakes, you know, those eco rounds, which they should have easily won and, you know, remained in the lead, especially on the T side, that would have played huge for them. So Epsilon is still, you know, coming into this, but I wouldn't have thought that London Conspiracy would be too worried as of yet, considering they are on the less favored side. But if FXYO keeps pulling off shots like that, they could get worried very, very quickly indeed.
Yeah, Rubino, we've already seen him infiltrate that smaller B bomb site by himself. He's actually left Kiyoshima on only 22 points of health. And Epsilon really need to lock down this B bomb site. And in my opinion, I think it'd be nice to see them smoke them up with banana from CT spawn. Push down, try and put your dominance down. Because GMX did it, GMX and Kiyoshima did it in the last round. And granted, London Conspiracy were on an eco, but judging by the movement of the London Conspiracy players, they weren't exactly expecting it.
No, they definitely weren't. It was something different, and it worked for them. And of course, yeah, as you say, you can't really fully judge it because of the fact that the T-sides were on an
eco. And the thing about Counter-Strike is it's so crucial to try and use that surprise element to your advantage.
Exactly, exactly. You know, when teams start to get used to the strategies that you're using and then can easily counteract it, that's the time where you need to start to change things up.
Surprise, surprise, they're at the top of banana and they're going to try and go towards this B-bomb site again. And you know what? I think they'll get in there.
Yeah, and we've seen FXYO actually starting to rotate back through CT spawn. So he's just hanging around in the middle, but they're going to get caught in a whole world of trouble if they're not careful any second here. Ooh. Not unless Kiyoshima performs like that. He does get two, but in comes the T's, and that's three straight frags in a row for London Conspiracy. In they go on the B-bomb site. And even with Kiyoshima picking up two huge kills as the Norwegian side entered that B-bomb site, it wasn't enough to stop them.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm pretty sure Shox is just pretty much tired of having to continuously keep on rotating towards this B-bomb site. Both CTs coming from Nana. Polly will get his third of the round, and he might be able to make it for PRB, not PRB, sorry, GMX. The Epsilon leader is going to try and shut down the two Norwegians at the back of this bomb site. Dropped PRB, but Polly says, right, thank you very much. I'm going to have my second four-man of the game so far. And you can see Epsilon, Shox is definitely not happy. I think he's probably talking about that B-bomb site. They haven't been able to hold it at all.
No, they haven't, and it'll be interesting to see what their discussions are like in there. Obviously, we can't have a listening, or we can't understand it with it being French, but you can kind of just sense with the body, you know,
I
kind
just
of
imagine
actions.
We're getting a lot of Sacre Bleus.
Yeah, exactly. You know,
we losing the B-bomb site.
Exactly, exactly. You can kind of get a sense for what Shox is going to be talking about there.
Epsilon, really, in my opinion, they can't afford to give London Conspiracy one more round. No. That's it. London Conspiracy have hit the, I wouldn't say ideal five. In an ideal world, you'd want 15 rounds, but on the T side of Inferno, you should always aim for that landmark of five rounds. And London Conspiracy have got it really early on.
They do indeed, but FXYO stationed up here in Archway is going to be met any second. He does start to peek out, put shots down range, and he's going to knock Rubinho down to 37 HP. In comes the smokes, in comes the molotovs, in comes absolutely everything you can imagine, just to try and slow those T down. And have a look, as soon as they get scared of that A bomb site, where do they go? Back to where they know they can push, back to where they know that Epsilon have been relatively weak so far, where they can get onto the bomb site, and that's going to be B. Let's see if Epsilon can hold strong so far. It's looking good for them from what we can see, and that's four straight frags, make that five, and finally Epsilon show some resilience on that B-bomb site. And I hope Shoxy's taking some of his words back if he was starting to moan at them about that B-bomb site, because that was impressive.
Thing is, though, that push towards the B-bomb site from London Conspiracy was a lot different to the pushes we saw previously. Previously, London Conspiracy had their hearts set on the bomb site. Smoke CT, smoke coils, and in that case, they got done by a player in CT with that M4 just playing around the corner. So maybe if they hadn't panicked when trying to infiltrate the A bomb site, maybe if it just wasn't a YOLO push, as I like to call it, and they'd actually calmed down, treated back to mid, maybe back to second mid, but Rubinho is going to get the CZ75 kill, and Chewy, I'll go back to what I was saying later, but do you think they'll be able to win this pistol round? We've seen them do it before so far this game, but maybe I've jinxed it.
Yeah, I think it's going to be difficult considering the fact that, they haven't got the most overpowered pistols in there, although they can all do damage. It's not like they've got five CZ75s and some Deagles in the mix. And another thing to add is they didn't have any grenades, I don't believe, or any armor, which, you know, is quite a considerable proportion of things when you have to weigh things into schedule. GMX is going to pick up Polly there, and he takes down PRB to finish things off. So only one frag onto Kiyoshima, unfortunately, but to be fair to London Conspiracy, they didn't really have much to play with there in the bank. And heading into the next round, it's going to be 6-5 in favor of the CT, so still very, very, very close.
Yeah, I think credit where it's due to FXYO. Epsilon knew that LC were definitely going to be on an eco, and the second he heard people at Banana, the second his teammates got that frag on Banana, he thought, right, I'm just going to push down mid and try and basically constrict where London Conspiracy can go. And London Conspiracy, they're going for the double eco by the looks of things, and probably the right decision when you look at their current economical situation.
Indeed. And, you know, we pointed out earlier, and there's no harm repeating it again, about how London Conspiracy already on the T side, they have got five rounds on the board, and it's looking likely, you know, like, I'm definitely going to predict that they can take maybe another one or two here, and if they can, I think they're going to be in good stead to maybe take this entire match, but we will see Epsilon holding strong here. That's going to be FXO, second of the round. In comes the pistol, but he's going to get shot in the head with that CZ75 from Rubino. SF gets the revenge kill onto him. Yes, this is an eco, so we won't get too hyped over this one, but Kiyoshima pulls out the grenade just at the wrong time. He's going to back away and does clean up the kill eventually onto Polly, all in the hands of PRB. Nice headshot onto Sharks there in pit, but he's still in a 1v3 situation and he's nowhere near the bomb. GMX shuts him down. 7-5 is your score, and Epsilon with a two-round lead. And now we're going to see the T's eventually buy up after two rounds of eco.
Yeah, and this is the thing now. If Epsilon managed 10-5, pretty standard for them. I don't think they'd be too downhearted at all. But give London Conspiracy that sixth round. And when me and Anders were actually doing Epsilon and iBUYPOWER yesterday, we were both emphasizing how much of a difference on the CT side of Inferno 9-6 and 10-5 actually makes. Yeah. It is ridiculous. And Epsilon, quite simply, they can't afford to give away any more rounds.
No, they can't. And I have a feeling here that London Conspiracy definitely, you know, this is going to be a crucial round. I think that they can definitely take this one away, but if they can't win the round, I'm sure they're going to be definitely aiming to get that bomb down at least and keep that economy rolling. So if they go into round number 14 and 15, they've got some money in the bank. SF, that was a lovely nade, as you do say, 65 HP down for him. And you can see all the T's stacked up on Banana as things stand. We've got two players actually rotating back out of there at the second, so not all fully committing to it at the second. Epsilon still holding strong on the A bomb site as well as the B, although we have actually seen FXO starting to rotate now though, and with 54 seconds on the clock, it'll be interesting to see who gets these first picks and whether the London Conspiracy can get the entry frag if, of course, they do choose to go to B.
Somehow PRB and GMX have completely avoided each other. I'm not sure if PRB saw him. They're literally that meters CS away timing from each other. PRB, all he has to do is look left, and I think GMX will have heard him, and damn.
There we go. That's a great thing about CS. You know, you just have those crazy CS timings where you just, you know, if they'd have been a split second earlier, the whole round could have been completely different. And that's why we love it. But in comes the push towards Banana. Now that London Conspiracy have worked out that they're a man down, they need to do something quickly. There's only 16 seconds left on the clock. And FXO with a double spray down with the CZ75. And Epsilon holding strong once again on the B-bomb site. I think they've started to learn what London Conspiracy do there. And they'd already got, you know, another player stacked up on there who'd rotated over from A. And that's going to be, once again, 8-5. So Epsilon with three rounds on the trot at the very least. And they're starting to, you know, warm up here and show how dominant they can be on the CT side.
Well, LC, they're going to be econed. But yeah, next round when they buy up, I'd really like to see what they're made of on the A-bomb site. We really haven't seen them try and strategically push the A-bomb site. All we've seen them do, as far as the A-bomb site is concerned, is fake it and then go all the way back down towards Banana and B. So like you said, it looks like Epsilon have stepped their game up a little bit. Shocks had a word with the boss in GMX. They've changed things round on the B-bomb site, and I want to see what London Conspiracy are made up on the A-bomb site.
Indeed, it looks like this could be over pretty quickly unless FXO gets shut down and then they start to make their way through. That's going to be a triple for FXO. And we can see GMX finishing it up as well. So there we go. Good smile from him. Happy with that round. Yes, it was an eco, but hitting some good shots with his AWP there in hand. And now 9-5 is going to be your score. We're into the last round of the first half. And Polly's picked up an AWP here, Kainite. So they're really going all out. This is going to be a very interesting round. And this is going to be so crucial. You know, as you said, you were talking to Anders yesterday. 9-6 to 10-5, huge difference on Inferno.
Well, we've already seen what happens when Epsilon lose a man on the B bomb site. It becomes a 2-2 split from the CTs. FXO going aggressive at Banana. The CZ comes out.
2 HP.
2 HP. He has to fall back, but he will live to fight another day. And Rain is one of those players. He is a quality player. We've seen what he can do throughout this entire tournament. And 2 HP, to be fully honest, is plenty for a player of his caliber. And now we're starting to see why LC went in, all in as you called it, and bought up the AWP. I said I wanted to see them go towards the A bomb site, and they are doing so.
They are indeed, and Shox is going to get caught if he's not careful down there in pit. He saw those grenades coming his way and he backed away from them, but it doesn't stop the third one as he's been knocked down to 45 HP. He's still holding strong though, and he's going to be able to pick up one frag, and he spotted them as well. But as we can see, I believe it's actually going to be Rain who's already on that A bomb site. FXO is going to spot him, so he goes down. That's going to make things all even onto a 3-on-3 situation. Very, very close indeed, but Epsilon holding strong. The bomb has been planted. I don't think it's going to be enough. Maybe it will be. It's all in the hands of SF. He's going to get shut down London Conspiracy holding strong. Great T round for them. And what that is going to do now in terms of the entire game and how we're going to proceed into the second half, I have a feeling that that round could be pretty crucial.
Well, again, my question to LC was, what can you do on the A bomb site? And they've just proven to us there that they are capable of taking the
A bomb site,
despite their persistence on the B bomb site. I can understand why they were so persistent on the B bomb site, but I'm happy to see them take that all-important sixth round. Because Chewy, if they end up winning this pistol round on the CT side, oh yeah, you're pointing it out, but let me finish my point.
Yeah.
If they end up winning this pistol round on the CT side and go on to win the next two rounds, it'll be tied at 9-9. And if we can just quickly get the scoreboard up, Mr. Spectator, Shocks, 6 kills, 7 deaths.
I believe yesterday he didn't get over 10 frags. I mean, I know, well...
Not to single him out.
No, you don't want to single him out. It's just that when people call him Shoxalon, you know, this team Shoxalon, and just like, this is Shox, his team and everything like that, he's the guy who carries and stuff like that.
And that can have a mental... It can make a mental difference to you as a player.
Exactly. And I'm pretty damn sure that he was bottom fragging against iBUYPOWER yesterday, which could have been one of the, main reasons that they actually lost that game, and that was still close. They only lost by 3 rounds, let's think about. But, you know, you can't take anything away from the rest of the team. Even the fact with Shox bottom fragging like that, you can't ever take anything away from the rest of the team, because when they need to, they're pulling their weight and starting to do some work here. So, interesting gun choices. Rubinho is going to get those dual Berettas out indeed. And we will see who's going to take this pistol round. But with 1 minute left on the clock, no casualties as of yet in round number 16.
Yep, well, this is the man of the hour on your screens right now in Shox. Let's see whether he can redeem himself. He's slowly sneaking round Arch. He's just waiting to see if a CT will pop out. He obviously doesn't have the same X-ray vision we do. PRB is in fact going to be playing from Library. And with the P2000, I was going to say he might get himself a nice crisp headshot, but that's a great smoke from Epsilon. I think we saw them do this yesterday against iBUYPOWER. PRB knows exactly what they're doing. Look who it is. It's Skirk in CT spawn. And now Shox is absolutely surrounded, by angry Norwegians who just want to drop him, want to make sure he keeps playing as poor as he has done so far. And I think it's going to be very, very difficult for Epsilon to really win this one in a 3-versus-1 situation with Kiyoshima planting. Skirt comes in, time to perfection, and you can see the disappointment on their faces.
Yeah, you can, but they did manage to get the bomb down, so it's not all completely lost. You know, they did have a good chance there, and it was very, very close timing, but they were able to get the bomb down, which is something that they can take away from that round.
But this is the thing from this point on. I can't remember who won the pistol round in the first half, but we saw the team who won the pistol round, instead of capitalizing and making it 3 in a row, they lost the round.
It completely
messed up their economy, and then the team with the good economy, with the big weapons, ended up losing that round.
Yeah, it was London Conspiracy who won the first pistol round, and then Epsilon, you know, because we kind of called it after yesterday when they were taking ECOs that they were going to do it again.
Long story short, fingers crossed, but at least I hope for LC that the same thing that happened in the first half doesn't happen again, because they need to capitalize on this. They need to get 2 more rounds. They need to make it even Steven at 9-9.
Well, those, you know, important pistol rounds and those important eco rounds and anti-eco rounds that do follow, of course, are so crucial to this game. You can't really emphasize it enough. But in round number 17, we're in a 4-on-4 situation as things stand. We can see that that bomb is actually now in banana. It's going to get taken away from there by the looks of things. We've only got one player on the B bomb site, which is actually going to be Skirk. And just behind him in CT spawn is actually going to be PRB. So he's just waiting for that, seeing if anybody's going to be pushing through arches, and it doesn't look like they will be, and he needs to get over to the speed bomb site pretty quickly, because Skirt will have called out that smoke. He's in a good position now, so let's see what Epsilon can do. They have been able to pick up a FAMAS, which was of course dropped by Polly, but they're taking things slowly. They're not, you know, wasting any time. Well, they are wasting a lot of time indeed, actually. Sorry, GMX gets 1-on-1 to Skirk. PRB does respond. Is the rotation going to come in quickly? They are going to be able to get the bomb down here once again on the B bomb site, and they are going to be able to pick up weapons. So it's actually going to be a 2-on-2. FXGO and Shox versus Rubinho and Rain. And I have a feeling that Epsilon could potentially close out this round.
Yeah, the flashes are going to go in towards Ruin. Shox with the CZ is going to drop Rain. It's 2-versus-1. Rubinho with only a FAMAS in hand. And is he going to run away? No, he's going to go for it. He's absolutely surrounded by angry Epsilon players. Rubinho with one. Out come the dualies.
Wow.
Rubinho with the double. But the question at hand now is whether there's enough time to defuse. And the answer is no.
Nope, so not going to happen, unfortunately, which does mean then that Epsilon again have taken another eco round in this game. And what that is going to do to the London Conspiracy squad, I am not quite sure. But having a look at the scoreboard there, 19-10. is what it's going to be. And I'm not quite sure at this second. Apparently, the match has been stopped for a second by the admins, but it looks like we should be ready to go any second. I hope we are, but still, let's just talk about that round a tiny bit quickly whilst we work out what's going on here.
They're just playing.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. But still, you know, we can analyze that because that was just a crazy round. It was just absolutely back and forward.
Well, if you ask me, LC shouldn't have lost the B bomb site. We're seeing. No. I didn't want to see a repeat for LC as to what happened in the first half, and they've only gone and repeated what happened in the first half. They have the bigger weapons. There's no excuse to lose the B bomb site, even though Polly went down early and gifted a FAMAS to the T's.
So, round number 18 it is, and it's a 4-on-4 situation as things stand. London Conspiracy are on the eco here, but Skirk has actually got a FAMAS in hand, so I'm not sure how much that's really going to play into factor whatsoever, especially considering the fact that the only man with armor on the CT side is actually going to be Rubinho. And they've got 4 AK-47s to go up against, who are fully armored and have got lots of grenades in the bank as well. So you would expect this to be another round here for the French team of Epsilon, but you never quite know. This game has been back and forth, and we've seen some really weird rounds. But that's what we like to see. You know, we like it when teams can change it up and when the pressure can kind of get to people and you can lose those anti-eco rounds, especially when so much is on the line. You know, and technically these teams are playing for money, of course, because whoever wins this game is confirming themselves to be in the prize pool.
It's going to be Skirk to get first blood onto the head of Shox. It's 3 versus 4. So weapon-wise, it's advantage Epsilon. But numerically, it's advantage London Con. And hello, GMX has somehow managed to make his way all the way onto this A bomb site. He's going up towards he's going up towards Graveyard. He's going to get two. Skirk, but they have no idea, Chewie, that Skirk is hiding in pit. It's 3 versus 2. If he can just play it patient, I don't know if Kiyoshima saw him. They'll have definitely heard him now. So I think he's got to wait for Polly to rotate and try and do some sort of coordinated push. That's a brilliant USP kill from Polly. I definitely didn't expect that. Polly was 2 versus 1, but GMX is going to get his fourth for the round. And hey, GMX, he often comes under a lot of stick. But to be honest, all CS leaders always come under a lot of stick.
Of course.
They're always so focused in on trying to motivate their team. They're trying to focus on the tactics that they sometimes underperform. If I'm going to be fully honest, I think Robin has done really, really well this tournament.
Well, we're into round number 19, and I have a feeling here that there's a chance of Epsilon starting to run away with this one. London Conspiracy are going to buy, but three players haven't got head armor, and they've only really got five smoke grenades to play with, which, yeah, of course, are important, but it's just, I don't know if it's going to quite be enough. It could be, but with the fact that Epsilon are really stacking up here on this B bomb site, they could push in quickly and get those entry frags. The round could already be over in a matter of seconds. We'll have to see, though. In comes the push onto the B bomb site. Epsilon wasting no time whatsoever. Polly is going to get one. So does Skirk, though. Polly gets his second of the round. Kiyoshima eventually responds, but good holding on the B bomb site coming in from the CT side. It's not quite over yet, but it's a 4 versus 2.
There's the bomb has gone down, which even if Epsilon end up losing this round, at least they'll have that small cash injection. Shox is all eyes on Ruins, and the second I say that, he turns his back. But Shox, we've seen him do 1 versus 4s before. We've seen him do 1 versus 5s, but unfortunately that round, he was no match, especially in his current form, to Rubinho's M4, who has played well as well.
Yeah, he has. You can't take anything away from him. So the defuse is going to come in with plenty of time left on the clock for them. And London Conspiracy do pick up the round there. And they're going to be able to keep, of course, those four rifles. So Polly the only one who's actually going to have to buy there, which somebody's, I think, going to drop from. Yeah, it looks like Rubinho did, I think. So into round number 20 we go. Only 10 more left at the very maximum, and we can see the score is 11-8. It's definitely not all over yet, and the terrorists have been forced down onto an eco, even though they did get that bomb down in the last round. You can't put it past Epsilon winning this one, you know, and I'm not going to say that it's just going to be straight 11-9 here because of the fact that Epsilon have already got so many eco wins so far in this match.
Yeah, and I like this from London Conspiracy. They know they've got the weapons, so they're pushing down, they're trying to eat up as much of the map as they can, but it does look like the train of terrorists is going to be coming all out of apps. Rain not managing to drop one, and let's wait and see as to whether this will end up being a problem for them, because I think the terrorists do have full control of the A-bomb site, and they should be able to plant, and there you go.
That's the main aim on an eco, of course, as we all know, to get that bomb down. And they've not only got the bomb down, they picked up a rifle there. Shox is going to get another one onto Rubinho, and we said that I'm not going to call 11-9, which some people would, considering, you know, teams are on ecos, because of the fact that Epsilon looking so great on these eco rounds. Skirk has responded, though, and it's a 3-on-3, but back and forth, actually. Frank's going down all across the floor. Skirk's only on 8 HP. It's back and forward. And FXJO is going to be the last one left alive. He's got to push through. Try and kill those defusers. It's not going to work, though. And London Conspiracy pumped there, as you can see. Just about managing to pick up that round. But considering the fact that Epsilon started with CZ75s and I think a Deagle in the mix as well, that was a bit close for comfort.
It was, but they won't give a damn.
No.
They won't give a damn. 11-9, this is getting close, Chewy. And all they care about is winning the round.
And if I'm Nick right now, I'm starting to get a tiny bit nervous because with the way that this game is going so far, with the way that it's looking, there is a good potential for a draw here. And that's not even, you know, thinking about the potential of, you know, what that draw will do in terms of the standings for the quarterfinal stages. It's just, regardless of that, it's just looking like one of those games which could potentially go that way.
Well, I think I saw a post on HLTV yesterday where someone was saying, what if Epsilon and London Conspiracy have agreed to finish this game 15-all?
Yeah.
At an event in London, which would end up being a conspiracy with London Conspiracy. So hats off to whoever wrote that. Yeah. It made me chuckle.
Quite a confusing one. I'm sure some people had to read that a couple of times over just to make sure that they understood what that post was about. But yeah, indeed. I mean, as we talked about earlier, I'm sure these teams are going to try their best. But whoever does win this one in the end is going to face up against either Dignitas Titan or Virtus Pro. And the loser will be out. It's just really as simple as that. But round number 21 we go, only two rounds separating the teams. FXJO has been able to pick up the big green gun in the AWP, but he's already been knocked down to 48 HP, so he needs to be careful. He doesn't like he's going to be careful, though, and he could be met by PRB just in the corner any second, though. In come the flash grenades, in comes the smoke, but PRB is going to get two, eventually shut down by Kiyoshima. But let's see what this is going to do now to the terrorist push.
Yep, Rubinho is in library. Rain is going to have a heck of a load of terrors to try and deal with. One of them being Shox. Polly on the A bomb site drops one, might get the double. Out comes the USP. And it's going to be Rain to get rid of the trash on that B bomb site. 11-10.
They're pumped. You know, they're ready to go. We can see on the screen there. You know, they're ready to do this.
Of course, they were the big underdogs coming into this tournament.
Of course.
I mean, last week, no one even expected them to beat Navi. And in a few weeks' time, they're going to be on their way to Cologne.
Yeah, and it's great to see them perform well. I mean, you know, although I've been new to the Counter-Strike scene, you know, I know that Norway, you know, they can have a good representative. And you said yesterday that they always have the potential.
Because you have a Norwegian girlfriend, and you're going to be very, very biased.
I'm not
going to
be biased
teams.
Just because I have a special relationship with Norway, and I love the place, so I'm not going to be biased on that sense. But it is nice, you know, when a country that you love has a good team with a sport that you love as well. But here we go. Don't want to take anything away from Epsilon because they are such a strong squad as well. And Shoxy, the man of the hour, is going to be able to pick up one. SF gets another one with a CZ75. And once again, London Conspiracy struggling on an anti-eco round. They have been able to pick up another frag, but the T-side have got the bomb down. Great grenade from Rain comes in to even up the situation. They have got rifles. The terrorists haven't been able to pick up anything as of yet. But still, why do London Conspiracy keep getting these close anti-eco rounds coming their way? I don't quite get it. They are going to be able to finish things off and even up the score 11-11. But wow, this game is crazy.
Well, you asked that question, and the answer is simple. You have M4s, I think they all had M4s, you have M4s, you stood on top of the B bomb site. Where were the nades going out towards Banana when you hear the rush coming in? Where was maybe the Molotov on the floor to slow it down? London Conspiracy, despite winning the round, you're right, they shouldn't have let them take the B bomb site so easily. They've got to start utilizing the Molotovs, which in my opinion, certain teams don't utilize enough. They've got to start using the nades. They've got to start using defensive smokes like we saw iBUYPOWER doing a lot on this very same map yesterday. And maybe we'll see them adjust their game. Only time will tell.
Only time will tell indeed. Round number 23 it's going to be. We've got the Battle of the Orbs with FXJO and Polly going head to head in this one. And again, I have a feeling here whoever takes this round could potentially take a couple on the trot and start to pull away with this one. You know, that's just an early call, and you know, anything can happen as we've seen so far in this game. But I just have a feeling that with how close this game is so far and the scores being tied up here, it's just going to come down to those single performances on those single rounds to determine this one at this rate.
Well, momentum, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, I always say this, Counter-Strike, you've got to be a good aimer, but you've got to be good mentally as well. And that's exactly what we saw from what we've seen so far in this tournament from London Conspiracy. They've got to make sure they don't become complacent at this point. Yes, they've done the hard work. They've brought it back to 11-11, but the real hard work starts now, where they fight towards that all-important 16th round, unless both teams are going to settle with 15, of course.
Well, I'm sorry, they're taking this incredibly slow. 28 seconds left on the clock. They're getting ready to push B. They've got one player which will actually be Shoxi over towards the A bomb site, and he's going to get shut down straight away by PRB. In come the grenades, though, as we can see. Lovely third-person shots there coming in. FXO is going to take down Skirk, so that's going to make things a 4-on-4 situation. Polly, with an AWP in hand, is going to be the last one left on that B bomb site until the other CT players try and move through. That bomb's been planted with only 7 seconds left on the clock. Polly eats a nade to the face and is knocked down to 54 HP, and this is looking potentially good here for the T's, especially with that kill on terrain. He has been knocked down to 23 HP, Kiyoshima there, but time for London Conspiracy to make a move, and it looks like they're going to try and do that now.
Yep, FXO spots one. Oh, misses the AWP shot, and you do have to wonder whether Rubinho will make him pay the price. Yes, he does, but that bomb is ticking. It's all down to Superfire to fight for his life. He's not going to be able to do it. And London Conspiracy, again, they've lost the B-bomb site, but they've managed to retake it.
Yeah.
And that's one of the things that London Conspiracy... Epsilon couldn't manage to do when they were on the CT side. No. We saw them lose the B-bomb site round after round after round, but they couldn't retake it. And that's where that's why London Conspiracy now have the lead. They've just had that small edge when it comes to retaking the bomb sites. And of course, a little bit of luck on their side as well.
They were able to retake that with the man disadvantage, of course.
I think one thing that's worth mentioning, though, is that Polly, he was the other player on that B-bomb site, and he fell back into ruins and waited for his teammates to rotate. Maybe Epsilon wouldn't have seen that from them, and I don't think we really saw that from them. Both players ended up getting wrecked when the terrorists pushed through Banana. And sometimes it takes the best players to be mature, to fall back, to know when to peek and when not to peek. And Polly knows exactly when to peek, and I think I just jinxed him.
And of course, you know, another thing that we have to quickly take into account before we get into this round is how big those two missed AWP shots were by FXO on the T side there. That could have really changed things up from the push from the CT side, but in comes absolutely havoc here once again on this B bomb site. It's going absolutely crazy. It's a 3-versus-2 situation in favor of the Norwegians, and they're looking very, very good indeed. They have got the bomb down here, though, do Epsilon. It's going to be Shoxi and SF taking on Rubinho, PRB, and Rain. They've just retaken the bomb site with a man disadvantage. Are they going to be able to retake it with a man advantage? It's all going to be left up to SF. He put a shot down, misses virtually every one of them, and you can see how excited they are to be able to take that round. Easy defuse, another great retake on the B bomb site, and London Conspiracy, 3 single rounds from progressing through into the quarterfinals and knocking Epsilon out.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
Predictions. I mean, obviously, we discussed it at the start of the game, but 13-11, what do you think is going to happen? Because by the looks of things, I think Epsilon can buy. I was confused a bit by the money. I didn't realize they already bought. But they lose this one, I think they might find themselves ecoing unless they force the buy. And, well, that smoke didn't exactly go according to plan, so maybe the CTs are going to push Banana, and they're going to find that the smoke's not actually there, and maybe one of the terrorists will end up getting taken out. Only time will tell. Rain falls back. And again, it's all about being the mature player to make the right decision, and that was the right decision from Rain.
Yeah, I mean, there's two ways that you can look at it, because if London Conspiracy do take this round, and they do take it relatively convincingly, it should, yeah, as we say, force Epsilon back down to an eco. But again, I know I've repeated it a lot, but you can't take anything away from it of how well we've seen Epsilon be doing on those eco rounds. And when it comes down to it, you know, their resilience may show on those, and they could come back into it very, very easily. So you asked me for predictions. I'm sorry, Kai, but I don't think I can quite yet, because, you know, I'm always wrong with predictions, and I'll call it one way, and then something crazy will absolutely happen, and it'll just go the complete other way.
Do you want my prediction?
Go for it.
15 all. I'm just trying to stir I'm just trying to stir up Twitch chat. No, it's all right. FXO with the big green gun. He's going to be peeking Arch, and this is going to be really interesting. It's going to be AWPER versus AWPER. And again, we see Polly get one over his opponent, AWPER. And that gives all the conspiracy the one-man lead, which they crave.
They do indeed. And Shox has actually been knocked down to 38 HP. 19 HP for PRB when he picks up that kill, and he gets a second. Kiyoshima does respond eventually, but that was two huge kills. Rubinho down in pit is going to try and respond. Polly taking so many shots into his face, and the counter-terrorists win, and look at how excited they are. 14-11 it's going to be. Yeah, I mean, this is good to see. You know, they're happy. They're looking forward to this. Of course, they've got a huge game coming up next, no matter whether they face up against Dignitas Titan or Virtus Pro. But coming off the back of a victory like this against Epsilon, and let's not forget Epsilon yesterday, they did beat NiP, you know. It's no mean feat against these guys.
And they played really well against iBUYPOWER.
They did. Yeah. They did play very well indeed. And you've got to wonder whether they would have been able to win that game if Shoxi hadn't bottom fragged. Again, you know, I don't want to put the whole weight of the team on him, but you know, you can't deny he's a considerable factor. So here we go, round number 26, London Conspiracy from Norway. I'm definitely not biased whatsoever, I promise.
Yeah, keep mentioning they're from Norway.
Two rounds away.
Yep, GMX preparing some sort of smoke towards this larger A bomb site. We initially saw London Conspiracy send three players, three CTs to be exact, towards a B bomb site, and now they're rotating round and they're going to put four CTs on the A bomb site. Great smoke towards Quad, but what can Rubinho do from behind here? He's got that M4, he's run out of bullets, he's being jumped on with an AK-47 from Super Fighter, and well, brilliant from Epsilon. Is the comeback real?
It could be. It definitely could be indeed. And if they keep taking bomb sites in that fashion, it wouldn't really be too difficult for them.
And
they just made that look easy.
The thing is, they just went all in. They went nice, fast and snappy. And we haven't really seen them do that. So maybe, just maybe, they found that small niche they need to put into place to unlock this London Conspiracy defense.
And another thing with London Conspiracy, I mean, of course, we had London Conspiracy bring up some good results as well. I mean, having a look yesterday, they did beat iBUYPOWER 16-11, which was a huge result. And obviously, they did finish out that one. But here, with so much on the line, you've also got to think about the mentality. And, you know, they know that they are only two rounds away.
Yeah.
Is that going to start to play into their minds? Are they going to start to get a bit shaky? What is going to happen? Yeah, a bit complacent as well. I don't know. This could still go either way. I'm not going to call it quite yet. Even though London Conspiracy are so close to advancing due to the quarterfinals, I'm not going to take anything away from Epsilon because they've certainly got the capabilities, as we saw in that last round, to do it quickly. And FXGO finally wins the Battle of the Orbs against Poly. And what's that going to do for the CTs now? How are they going to play this? They've still got three stacked up on A and one on B. And kind of this is looking, once again, pretty good for the terrorists.
Yeah, and we see Epsilon again going back to this slow, methodical approach. And a lot of teams who have this sort of free terrorist side, in the sense that, for example, take Fnatic, Pronax, he's a very free and open leader. He makes changes of calls during games. There isn't just one set strat, for example. And teams who play like that are all about the entry fragger. And it's why it's so important for Fnatic to have a JW. It's why Epsilon have improved so much after bringing someone like FXGO in. He gets the exit frags, he gives something for the rifles to rush in on and feed off.
Indeed, but Skurk, lovely shot there through the smoke, and he's going to pick up two. That could completely change this whole round alone. PRB's going to put shots down range, and SF we see knocked down to, I believe, only 34 points of health. Bomb has been planted, so in comes the potential retake here from London Conspiracy. We've seen them retake this bomb site so many times successfully. Skurk picks up his third of the round, if I'm not mistaken, and could he be the man to put London Conspiracy on match point? No, not quite. Yeah, Shocks shuts him down. 3 versus 2, 2 versus 2. FXGO goes down, Rubinho finishes them off. Have they got enough time to defuse? I believe they do, with plenty of time left. London Conspiracy, I can't take anything away from them. Their retakes on me, look at me, so happy. Their retakes on B, I don't know if they've actually had an unsuccessful one so far. I'd love to look back and see, because all the ones that I can remember, especially in this last couple of rounds or so, they've just been able to take it with relative ease.
Well, hopefully that's something Richard and Thorin can answer for you. Yeah. But here we go. What could potentially be the last round of this game? If London Conspiracy win this next round, make it 16, win the game, Epsilon will be going home. And Nip will be going through.
Oh, this is just crazy. This is why I love this best of one round robin format with six teams in a group and two groups, because it just really adds some crazy elements into it, especially when you get some teams pulling some crazy results on there. And Polly getting confident down Banana with that AWP. He does miss a shot. It doesn't matter though, because Skurk, he played so well in that last round and he's had a good game. And he's going to pick up the first frag of the round onto FXGO to make things a 5-on-4 situation as things stand. But the bomb's nowhere near there, as we can see. It's making its way up mid, actually, over near apartments, and it should be going to A, but the terrorists holding strong, still keeping 3 on A and 2 on B.
Yep, 5 versus 4 in favor of the Norwegians. And Chewy could be smiling about that. I'm mentioning Norway again. Good old Norway. But anyways, here we go. It's going to be Shocks, the headshot machine. But talking about headshots, it's going to be Kiyoshima to get that first frag for Team Epsilon, for the team from France. But the bomb has been left at the bottom of Banana, and it looks like they are going to try and go through CT spawn, but they've still got a very big and angry PRB to try and go through, Chewy.
They do. PRB getting those flash grenades downrange just to make sure that nothing's going to happen. And he's going to back away. Rubinho covering arches, though, just to make sure that nothing's going to happen. But he's going to get smoked off here. And what is that going to do? Because those two T players are going to pursue PRB and Rubinho get the kill zone. That's absolutely crucial here. Lovely cover work on the A-bomb site. Polly finishes up GMX. And Polly gets the second through the smoke. And I can even hear them shouting, GG on your screen. London Conspiracy not only knock out Epsilon, they advance themselves through to the quarterfinal stages in what some people would call a crazy upset.
Yeah.
And Nip, even though they didn't have the best of days yesterday,